Good morning, children. Welcome to today's class. 1 week ago, I have given you the work of workbook as the homework to complete 12 pages. So now 1 week is over. I think you might have completed. So the work for this week is from page number 13 up to the end of this chapter, that is page number 21. Up to that, you have to complete this week. You have to do this work, otherwise your work will not be completing and also you will not get the practice. So this work, this week you have to complete page number 13 to page number 21. So this chapter 1 is going to complete this week, and then this chapter 2 we will start the next week. Chapter 2, whole numbers. Next week we will start. Before that you have to complete up to page number 21. So this whole chapter 1 will complete. So this is about the workbook. And now, previous day we have completed exercise 7.2. Today we are going to start exercise 7.3. We are dealing with the chapter fractions. So in the beginning, in the introduction part only I have explained what is that fraction means. Whatever, what is used out of the total part means. For example, how much marks you are scoring in any of the exam, how much you have scored divided by the total marks. Like suppose you are scoring 20 out of 25, so 20 divided by 25, like this you are writing. So that is called as a fraction. And the simplest form also I have explained in the beginning of this chapter, in the introduction part, means dividing both numerator and denominator by the same number up to when they are not having the fraction, or you can say the common factor as 1. Up to that you have to just go on dividing. That is called as simplest form. So here the question is, write the fractions. Are all these fractions equivalent? So first of all you have to write the fractions of these. Some figures are given, you have to write out the fraction. And then you will just find it out in the simplest form, and then you have to tell whether these fractions are equivalent or not. So first we will write down how many parts are shaded. 1 part is shaded. Out of how many? 1 and 2. Total 2 parts are given. It is having only 1 as the common factor. It cannot be converted to more simplest form. So this is only the simplest form. The next one. 2 parts are shaded. Out of total 1, 2, 3, 4. Here table of 2. By the table of 2 it can be cancelled, or you can see the 2 is the common factor in both. So 2 ones are 2 and 2 twos are 4. So 1 by 2 getting equal to this 1 by 2. So yes, these two are equivalent. Coming to the next, total 1, 2, 3 parts are shaded. Out of total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 parts. So here you can see it can be cancelled by the table of 3. Means the common factor is 3. So 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. So here also you are getting 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 is the simplest form. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 parts are shaded. Out of total, how many total parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 parts total are there. It is cancelling by the table of 4. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So 1 by 2. It is also similar. So here 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2 and 1 by 2. So yes, these all are having same fraction, or you can say these are having the equivalent fractions. So just you will write down, yes, these all fractions are equivalent. Yes, all these fractions are equivalent. Then the B part. I am not drawing the figure, I am not just telling all the fractions. Just you can see in your textbook and write down for the shaded part. How many parts are shaded? 4 parts are shaded. First figure. 4 parts are shaded. Out of total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. By 12. So it is having more than 1 as a common factor. By the table of 4 it can be cancelled. 4 ones are 4, 4 threes are 12. Okay. Then the second figure. 1, 2, 3 parts are shaded. Out of total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It is coming in the table of 9. 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9. 1 by 3, 1 by 3, they are equivalent. Then coming to the third figure, 1, 2. Only 2 parts are shaded. Out of total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. Coming in the table of 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 threes are 6. Then the fourth figure, only one part is shaded, total 3 are given. It is directly 1 by 3, common factor only 1 by 3 only. Common factor is 1. Then the fifth figure, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 parts are shaded, out of total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Again, just count it. 6 parts are shaded. 5, 10, 15. 15 are there. So, it can be considered by the table of 3. 3, 2 are 6, 3, 5 are 15. Any other common factor? Only 1 is the common factor. So, here is the simplest form 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 3. But here it is 2 by 5. So, all the fractions are not equivalent. Only these 4 are equivalent. The 5th one is not equivalent. So, you will write just no, all the fractions are not equivalent. So, here we are completing question number 1. Coming to question number 3, here you can see the question is given, replace the box in each of the following by the correct number. Here it is not given or not asked whether you have to multiply or divide or how you are going to fill that box. Directly you can not fill this box. Definitely you have to either do some division or sometimes multiplication. How? You will come to know whether you are going to do multiplication or whether you are going to do division. If this left side numbers are small, if this left side numbers are small and the means both where both numerator are given, numerator and denominator are given, if that is small and where the box is given, if that is greater, means you are going to do multiply, because by multiplying you are getting the greater number. And if suppose like this, both numerator denominator where it is given it is more and the box where it is given it is smaller, then you are going to do division. Just keep this in mind. When the box is given, if that numerator or denominator is greater, then you are going to do multiply, and if that is smaller, then you are going to do division. Now see how we are going to find them. Directly you cannot fill this box, so you have to do some kind of calculation. Like, first you will write down the fraction, whatever is given. Then, into which number you will get 8. Where the numerator, whatever fraction, numerator or denominator which is given other than the box, that you write. 2 into which number you will get 8. So, that same number you will multiply here also. So, 2 into which number is 8? 2, 4 are 8. So, what number you have multiplied here, the same number you have to multiply for the other denominator also. 7 fours are 28. 4, 2 fours are 8, so 7 fours are 28. So, here in the box, you will get 28. This is your correct answer. Here space is not there, so I am not writing. You can write in this way also. So, 8 by 28 will be the fraction. Coming to the next part. Here this box is given, as I told, directly you cannot fill the answer. So, take this fraction where both numerator and denominator is given. And here this is the greater number, so you are going to do multiply. Okay, multiply, multiply for both numerator and denominator. Into which number you will get 10? 5 into 2 is 10, so 8 into 2. Here also the same numbers we are multiplying. So, 8 to 16. So, that means this box value is 16. Means the fraction is 16, not 10 by 16. So, only this box value is asked. So, replacing this box, box is equal to the value 16. Coming to this 3 by 5. It is a greater number, so definitely multiplication we are doing. 5 into which number is 20? 5, 4 is 20. So the same number for numerator also. 3, 4 is 12. That means the box value is 12. Now here, 45 by 60. Now this number is smaller than the number given. If you are going to do multiplication, it will be more. Even if you into 1, if you are doing, then 45, that is greater than 50. So multiply you cannot do. Here you are going to do divide. 45 divided by which number will give you 15? 45 divided by 3 will give us 15. So the same we are going to do for denominator also. 60 divided by 3, 3 to 6 and 1 0. That means the value of the box is 20. In this way you are going to find. Then the next one is also like B part, that you are going to try by your own. So here we have completed question. Coming to the next question, it is just similar like question number 3. As we have replaced the box by multiplying or dividing any of the number, for both numerator and denominator the same we are doing. Same here we have to do, but here the conditions are given that you have to either change the numerator or the denominator. So one fraction is given here, 3 by 5. 3 by 5 is the fraction given. 3 by 5 is the fraction given. Here you have to change the denominator as 20. Denominator you have to bring 20. So 5 into which number is 20? 5 into 4 is 20. So that same you have to do for numerator also. 3 4s are 12. So this is our answer. Understood? It is just like question number 3 only. Here the condition is given, denominator you have to bring 20. So 5 into 4 is 20. Same we are doing for numerator also. Here condition is given, numerator 9. Fraction given is 3 by 5. And the condition given is numerator you have to bring 9. 3 into which number is 9? 3 3 is 9. So the same you are doing for denominator also. 5 3 is 15. So this 9 by 15 is our answer. So now it is very simple. Everyone can do. 3 by 5 is the fraction given. Denominator you have to bring 30. 5 into which number is 30? 5, 6 are 30. Same we are doing for numerator also. 6, 3 are 18. So this is our answer. Here 3 by 5 fraction is given. Condition is given. Numerator must be 27. 3 into which number is 27? 9, 3 are 27. The same for the denominator also. That is 5, 9 are 45. So this is our answer. So here we have completed question number 4. Coming to question number 5 now. This also I have explained in question number 3, where you are going to do multiplication and where you are going to do division. If the box is given greater than the fraction given, then you are going to do multiply. And if the box or the numerator denominator given is smaller, then you are going to do divide. This I have explained in question number 3. So question number 4, both were greater, so with both the places we have done multiplication. Now here in question number 5, the numerator or the denominator which is given, here the smaller one is given and the fraction is little greater one. So definitely we are going to do divide here. So first we will write down the fraction. Fraction is 36 by 48 and here condition is given, numerator you have to bring 9. Numerator 9. Denominator we don't know. So 36, bringing the smaller number. How it is possible? By dividing. Dividing which number you will get 9? 9 into how many times is 36? 9, 4 is 36. So dividing by 4 you got 9. So the same thing we have to do for denominator also. So 4 was a 4, 4 2 is a 8. Means 12 we got. So this fraction is our answer. Nothing else more you have to do. Here 36 by 48 is the fraction given. Denominator is the condition given. 4 you have to bring. So it is the smaller one. So definitely you are going to do divide. Dividing which number you will get 4? 12, 4 is 48. So dividing by 12 you will get 4. So here also you will divide by 12 only. So 12, 3 is 36. That is 3 by 4. So 3 by 4 is the answer. This completes your question number 5. Coming to question number 6. Check whether the given fractions are equivalent. Here comma is given means two two fractions are given. You are asked to check whether these two are equivalent or not. Equivalent means equal. Equal, how you will get directly if you see they are not looking equal or they are not looking same. You are able to first convert it to the simplest form, both the fractions, if it is possible. And then only you are able to tell whether they are equivalent or not. So let us come to check the first one. The first 5 by 9. 5 by 9. Is there any number in which table both 5 and 9 will come? Means only one is the common factor in 5 and 9. No other common factor is there. It is only 5 by 9. No need to write that. Or else if you write also no problem. 5 by 9, only 1 is the common factor. Then 30 by 54. Here second time we are writing because that is the question part only. Here we are writing for solving. It is having only 1 is the common factor. No other common factor. So we are leaving it here only. Now 30 and 54. So just cancel. Starting from 2. So 2. 1 is 2, 2, 5 is 10, 15, 2, 2 is 4, 2, 7 is, then 3, 5 is 15, 3, 9 is 27. So here it came 5 by 9 and here also it is 5 by 9. So the both are equal means yes, these fractions are equivalent. So how it is possible to tell? Only after completing the calculation of simplest form. So, you will just write down, yes, they are equivalent fractions. Now, just coming to this one, 3 by 10. Is there any number table in which both these will come together? No, neither. No number is there in which 3 and 10 both together they will come. So, leave it like this only. Now, 12 and 50. Just table of 2, it will be cancelling. So, 2, 6 are 12. 2, 25 sir, then any other number? 2, 6 are 12, 2, 2 sir, 4, 2, 5 sir, 10, 6 by 25. By table of 3 is it possible? No. Table of 4? No. Any other number? No, it is not possible. So here it came 3 by 10, here it came 6 by 25. So it is not equivalent. So they are not equivalent, they are equal. And let us come this side, C part, 7 by 13 and 5 by 11. Here you can see 7 is one prime number. Prime number, remembering in previous chapter we have studied, 7 is the prime number, 13 is also the prime number, 5 is again a prime number, 11 is again a prime number. So when both numerator and denominator are prime numbers and they are separate, different. So 7 by 13 is not equal to 5 by 11 and they will not have any other common factor also. So they are not equivalent. So first one they are equivalent, second one not equivalent, third one also not equivalent. Coming to question number 7. Reduce the following fractions to the simplest form. Here we have directly cancelled and written. This way you cannot write if the question comes in exam for converting to the simplest form. You have to write in the way as I am telling you here. First you will write dividing by the smaller number by which you can do, dividing by 2. That is 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8, 2, 3 is 6 and 1 0. Then again divided by 2, that is 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 1s are 2, 2 5s are 10. Then again dividing. By 2 is it possible? No, it is not possible by 2 because 15 is not coming in that table. Then go for 3, dividing by 3. 3, 4s are 12 and same number. They must be the similar. 2, 2, here 2 and 2, here 3 and 3. These numbers must be similar for both numerator and denominator. 3, 5s are 15. Now 5 and 4. Here only 1 is the common factor. No other number is there in which both these numbers will come in similar common number table. So 4 by 5 is the simplest form. Understood? In this way you have to write and solve. Just one more I am telling, the rest you will try by your own. Here directly 0 and 0 is there. Directly you can go for 10. Because numbers will be reducing. 1 1 0 will directly reduce. So dividing by 10 means only 15 and 6 will be remaining. As such, if you are solving like this, 0 and 0 are cancelling. So 0 and 0, how you can cancel? By dividing by 10. So only 15 and 6 is remaining. By 2 it is not possible. So by 3 we will go. 15 divided by 3, 5. And 6 divided by 3, 2. 5 and 2 not coming in any common number table. Only 1 is the common factor. So 5 by 2 is the simplest form. This way you have to solve. So for A and B part I have solved and told you here. C, D and E, these three parts you will try by your own. So here we have completed question number 7. Coming to the next question now, question number 8. Here Ramesh had this much pencil, Shiloh had pencil and so much, whatever is given in the question. Here I have written on the board, you can see. Three persons' name is given and it is given in the beginning how many pencils they are having and after 4 months how many pencils they have used up. So now you are asked to write down the fractions of how many pencils they have used up and to check whether they have used their equivalent number of pencils or not. So three persons' names are given, Ramesh, Silu and Jamal. In the beginning they are having the number of pencils 20, 50 and 80. After 4 months, they have used up 10, 25 and 40 pencils. Now, you are asked to write down the number of fractions. How much pencil they have used up. So, used divided by the total they are having in the beginning. So, 10 out of total 20. Then, 25 out of total 50. 40 out of total 80. Then, simplest fraction you are going to find. 10 2s are 20, that means it is half. 50 2s are 25 2s are 50, that means it is also half. 40 2s are 80, that means it is also half. So they have used up equivalent number of pencils after 4 months. So here you have completed this question number 8. Question number 9 is the match the following. That you will try by your own. Just simplest fraction, simplest form you have to find and just match up. You will try this by your own. So like in this way you have completed exercise number 7.3. Next day we will start with exercise 7.4. Here we have completed exercise 7.3. And about the workbook I have told up to page number 12. Already you have completed in the last week. This week you are going to complete up to page number 21. In that way full of chapter 1 is going to complete this week. So this much we have done for today. Thank you for today's class.